Stop it. Tell the Father God and his sister is here.
No, wait a minute now.
Mama, they are singing Vespers. It's sacrilege.
Come on.
We will talk out.
No. Here. Giuseppe. Who knows the heart of a mother better than God? Giuseppe, come here. My son, your nephew, flesh of your flesh, what have you done to him? What sin did he commit? Murder, blasphemy, adultery? Why did you throw him out? Who do you think you are? The Pope? You. Of all people. My son broke a statue. And what about you, Giovanni? Remember Giancarlo's saloon on your 18th birthday? You broke every glass, every bottle, every chair in the place. Shall I go on, Father, Guardian? Remember Rosa Esposito and Amaya.
Ah, you have blasphemed enough.
What about Giuseppe? Does he stay?
We will discuss it in my office.
And sing with your brothers.
Charge here.
You look wonderful.
Oh, you think so?
Like the Father Garden.
Oh, yes? Oh. How is it in back?
Oh, it doesn't show at all. How are things in the kitchen?
See for yourself. No more calluses, no dirty fingernails, and the best of food.
I'm happy for you.
You're jealous because I took away your job.
No, no, you're wrong. I'm happy here at my home, my family.
Home? A pigsty? You're in trouble again. You know who's coming tomorrow?
No.
The Vicar General of the Franciscan Order, Bishop Dulce himself, to make his annual inspection.
Is that true?
You know what that means? It means the stable had better be clean or out you go. And this time, running home to Mama won't help.
I've been so busy. I will try to catch up tonight.
It's too late now. It's hopeless, hopeless. The stalls are filthy. They're not fit for goats and donkeys to live in.
Please, Gobble, leave me alone. I don't want to be thrown out again. Please, I have to work.
What's this doing on the ground? There's a place for the harness. It's supposed to hang on the wall.
Gobble. Get out of here. Get out! Get out of here!
Forgive me. Forgive me, I shouldn't have done that.
Uh-huh. finest wine in Italy.
Don't forget me at Christmas time.
This will be your greatest harvest.
The friars in Sicily grow a fatter olive.
Let me show you our lemon groves, Your
Excellency. Are we near the stables?
Your Excellency, you haven't seen the strawberries.
No,
or
no.
Or the vegetable garden.
Later, later.
The wine press?
Take me to the stables.
This way, Your Excellency.
Not very tidy, I must say. Who's in charge here?
Brother Giuseppe, my nephew.
Who's that?
A pig, Your Excellency.
Yes, yes, of course.
Hard at work, I see.
Allow me, Your Excellency.
Wake up! Wake up! How do you explain all this, Giuseppe? Well?
No. Show me.
They were late, Your Excellency. I almost lost the mother. She has been sick all week.
What men of you having 100 sheep and losing one of them does not leave the 99 in the desert and go after that which is lost until he finds it? Saint Luke.
Saint Luke?
Yes. This is the kind of young men we need in our order. True son of St. Francis. Good work, my son. And let it be a lesson to all of us. First things come first. Well, I see Brother Giuseppe is quite busy here. Help him to clean up the stable. I love the smell of manure. When I was a boy in Abruzzi, we were very poor, but we had a little farm. So there were two donkeys, a cow, and a little horse.
If we accept the traditional and the scriptural dictates of the Decalogue on the supremacy of the Father, then we must ask ourselves, does the glorification of the Son for his Father prove inequality in our consideration of the Blessed Trinity? And we must further ask ourselves, is this a supererogation of the Holy Ghost? For the answer to these seeming paradoxes of the Blessed Trinity, let us consult the Bishop of Hippo, St. Augustine himself, who says, truly, let them beware, lest the Holy Spirit be thought greater than both, because he glorifies the Son whom the Father glorifies, while it is not written that he himself is glorified either by the Father or the Son.
Li turchi se ce vanno, Michele ma e Michele ma, a riposare, a riposare, a riposare, a riposare.
Beautiful. Very beautiful, Giuseppe. I used to sing that song in Calabria, not at all fast. Very pleasant here now. Oh, may I join you?
Yes.
No, no,
I'll
no,
get
no.
you a stool.
No, 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 no ceremony. Here.
Oh,
yeah. Thank you. Sit down. Sit down. Give me a chestnut.
They're hot, Your Excellency.
How are the lambs?
Oh, they're sleeping. I gave them names.
Oh.
One is called Girolamo.
Yeah.
And the other one, Bartolomeo.
Beautiful night. Look at those stars.
Have you ever noticed? The longer you look, the more stars come out.
Yes. I wonder why. Brother Orlando would certainly have an explanation.
Oh, yes. Brother Orlando, he knows everything.
I just heard him try to explain the Trinity. Now it's more of a mystery than ever. Always troubled me, the Trinity. You know, Giuseppe, I could never really understand it. Just took it on faith. What about you? Does it trouble you?
No. There are three persons in one God. Father, Son, and Holy Ghost, all in one.
Yes, but that's for a child. But it's small comfort to a bishop who's supposed to know theology. See, I'm a peasant, Giuseppe, just like you. A practical man. So I understand only what I feel and what I see.
Look. Look, one blanket, and one, two, three folds in one blanket, three persons in one God, like the Trinity.
Brilliant, Giuseppe, simply brilliant. So now, let's talk some more.
Are you cold?
Oh, no, thank you. You know, seems to me that the more you study, the less you know, because when I was young like you, everything was so clear, so simple. But now, things you understand in your heart and soul, Giuseppe, are so, so difficult to explain. The Trinity, free will, first cause. Maybe you can help me.
Me?
You probably more than anyone. Do you mind my being here, Giuseppe?
Oh, no. No.
Well, then, let's have some chestnuts and talk.
And one night, when my parents were sleeping,
yeah.
I took my father's tape measure
yeah.
and put the donkey right in the middle of the two stacks of hay.
And did the donkey starve to death?
No.
No.
No, Nino ate both of them.
Oh, heavens, I'd better get back to my room before Father Rasby comes looking for me. Well, Giuseppe, I don't know about you, but it's been a most enjoyable night for me.
Oh, for me, it was so. I'm only afraid I talked too much.
We both did, like two nuns in the kitchen. Yeah, but I feel better now. Have you ever thought of the priesthood, Giuseppe?
No. I can hardly read and write.
Reading and writing, any fool can do that. But the sacred calling is for a favored few. Comes from God. Think about it. Oh. Thank you for the chestnuts.